coming to total datas account, the format will be again of the ledger account, where date particulars general folio amount and date particulars general folio amount. So here, when coming to the total debtors account, we are going to prepare to ascertain sales. So in question, we can see that sales is not given. So out of total debtors account, we are going to find out the sales. So coming to total debtors account, it is an asset where today or tomorrow we are going to receive the amount. So first, the opening entry will be recorded in the debit side, and coming to the credit side, the closing entry will be recorded. Along with that, what is the cash received or any return inward or any bad debts or any discount allowed will be considered in the credit side. So now, coming to the total debtors account, opening entry will be in the debit side, balance brought down 40,000. Then we have bad debts in the illustration, where we are going to record in the credit side, bad debts 2000. Then we have return inwards. So what goods we have sold, in that we have return inwards. We are receiving back the goods, so that will be considered in the credit side, return inwards 4000. Then we have discount allowed, again in the credit side, discount allowed 3000. Then we have cash received, so where again it will be recorded in the credit side, cash 1 lakh. And then we have bills receivable, which is transfer from bills receivable account, so that again will be recorded in the credit side, bills receivable, in bracket we can write transfer from bills receivable account, in the outer column 30,000. Then we have closing balance of total debtors account, so again in the credit side, balance carried down 80,000. So now we have to close the total debtors account so that we can find the total sales. So coming to the credit side, total we have 2,19,000. The same total will be recorded in the same line in the debit side, 2,19,000. So 2,19,000 minus 40,000, the difference will be 1,79,000, which is nothing but the sales. So sales, in bracket we can write balancing figure. Same like total debtors account, we have to prepare total creditors account to find out the purchases. Even purchases is not given in the question, so that we are preparing total creditors account to find out purchase. So when coming to the creditors, it is a amount which we have to pay today or tomorrow for the credit purchases. So purchases is a liability where opening balance will be in the credit side and the closing balance will be in the debit side. Then format remains the same here. So let us record the first entry in the credit side, balance brought down 50,000 in the credit side. So then we are going to record the discount which is received in the debit side, discount received 5000. Then again the cash payment was made, that will be again recorded in the debit side, cash 80,000. Then again we have a transfer from bills payable account, again we are going to record in the debit side, bills payable, in bracket, transfer from bills payable account, in the outer column 45,000. Then we have closing balance which is given in the illustration. So again in the debit side, balance carried down 40,000. So now by closing the account, we are going to find out the purchases, where debit side total is 1,70,000 and credit side total will be 50,000. So difference what we have, that will be considered as purchases. So debit side total is 1,70,000. Same we are going to write in the credit side, in the same line, 1,70,000. Minus the opening balance, so difference is 1,20,000, which is nothing but purchases, in bracket, or in bracket you can write balancing figure. Let us take another illustration where we have to find out the net sales, so that we have to prepare total bills receivable account and total debtors account. So when coming to the illustration, we have the information is supplied by Sudha. So from that we have to calculate the net sales. So information provided is debtors, so which is on April 1st 2005, which is nothing but opening debtors 65,000, debtors as on March 31st 2006, closing debtors 50,000, opening balance of bills receivable 23,000, closing balance of bills receivable 29,000, cash received from debtors 3,02,000, discount allowed 8,000, cash received against bills receivable 21,000, bad debts 14,000, bills receivable, dishonored. So these are the bills which were dishonored: 20,000 cash sales, 2,25,000 sales return, 17,000. So by this information, first we have to prepare a total bills receivable account. So where we are going to follow the ledger account format. So the title will be total bills receivable, date particulars general folio amount, and date particulars general folio amount. So left hand side debit and right hand side credit. So when coming to the total bills receivable account, so receivable is what? It is a amount which we are supposed to receive. So here, when coming to the receivable, it is an asset and opening balance will be in the debit side. So when coming to the debit side, so we are going to take the opening balance first. So opening balance 23,000. Then the information provided is cash, where the bill were honored, so where the cash was received. So that will be recorded in the credit side. Bills honored, or the entry will be cash 21,000. Then again we have bills receivable dishonored, so that will be recorded again in the credit side. Bills receivable dishonored 20,000, and closing balance is given 29,000. And the difference value will be debtors, where the bills receivable which will be transferred to the total debtors account. So the total of the credit side is 70,000, and the same will be brought down to the debit side, where 70,000 minus opening balance, so difference will be 47,000. So debtors in bracket bills receivable and balancing figure. Then we are going to prepare total debtors account, where the title will be total debtors account and format remains the same. Again coming to debtors, debtors is what? It is nothing but the credit sales, where the amount is supposed to be received. So again it is an asset, opening balance will be in the debit side. So on the 1st April 2005, opening balance 65,000. Then we are going to record the entries which were given in the question, where we have received a cash. So it will be recorded in the credit side. Cash received 3,02,000. Then we have discount allowed, again in the credit side. Discount allowed 8,000. Then we have sales return, again in the credit side. Sales return 17,000. Then we have bad debts 14,000. Bills receivable which were transferred from the totals bills receivable account, so that will be 47,000. In bracket you can show transferred from bills receivable account. And even we have closing balance of total debtors account, which is 50,000, where opening was in the debit side and closing will be in the credit side, 50,000. Then we have bills receivable which were dishonored, that we are going to record in the debit side. Bills receivable in bracket dishonored 20,000. Now we are going to close the total debtors account, and we are going to find out the difference, which is nothing but the sales. So now the total of the credit side is excess, which is 4,38,000. The same will be recorded in the same line of the debit side, 4,38,000 minus the opening balance and bills receivable dishonored. The difference will be 3,53,000. So that is what sales balancing figure. So now we have to compute the net sales. So let us see how we are going to calculate the net sales, where we are going to apply the formula here, or you can say it as equation. Net sales is equal to cash sales plus credit sales minus sales returns. So where we have cash sales of rupees 2,25,000. So let us take 2,25,000 plus credit sales which we have ascertained out of total debtors account, which is 3,53,000. So here 2,25,000 plus 3,53,000 less sales return, which we have 17,000. So here 2,25,000 plus 3,53,000 minus 17,000, and the net sales will be 5,61,000. Let us take another illustration where Mr. Om Prakash did not keep his book of accounts under double entry system. From the following information available from his records, we have to prepare a profit and loss account for the year ending on March 31st, 2005, and a balance sheet as on that date, and depreciate the washing equipment at 10% per annum. So now we have a summary of cash where we have receipts and we have payments. So we can have a look on the summary of cash where we have debit side entries, balance brought down, cash sales, received from debtors, and we have payments, cash purchase, paid to creditors, sundry expenses, cartage, drawings and balance carried down. Then other information provided is we have opening balances as well as closing balances, where we have debtors, creditors, stock of material, washing equipment, furniture, discount allowed during the year and discount received during the year. So by this information we have to prepare a trading and profit and loss account, then we have to prepare a balance sheet. So now let us start with the trading and profit and loss account, where the title will be in the books of Om Prakash, trading and profit and loss account for the year ended on March 31st 2005. So coming to trading and profit and loss account, the format will be expenses or losses, then amount, then again revenues or gains, then amount. So here when coming to the trading account, we are going to record the opening stock and closing stock in that, and purchases and sales and any direct expenses which were incurred in the place of production. So first we are going to record the opening stock in the debit side or in the expenses side. So opening stock 10,000, then we have purchases 28,100 and cartage 2,000. Then we are going to record the sales in the credit side, sales 74,400 and closing stock 16,000. So difference what we are going to get here, if the difference was in the debit side it is a profit, if it is in the credit side it is a loss. So let us make the total of credit side, where we have 90,400. Same total we are going to record in the debit side, 90,400 minus the entries we have in the debit side, the difference will be 50,300, which is nothing but gross profit carried down. And trading and profit and loss account were continuation of two accounts. So now we have done with the trading account, and the same will be continued for profit and loss account. So same rule was followed here, nominal account rule, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. But what is the difference between the trading account and profit and loss account? In trading account we have recorded the direct entries or the expenditures which were directly incurred in the place of production. But when coming to the profit and loss account, we are going to record all indirect expenses and indirect incomes which were not incurred in the place of production. So but we are going to start up with the net profit or net loss which is carried from the trading account. So we have net profit in trading account which was in the debit side, and it will be carried down to the debit side. So here, so carried down was in the debit side and brought down will be in the credit side. So the profit was 50,300, and the same will be recorded after the total gross profit brought down 50,300. Now the entries which were indirectly incurred, that will be recorded in the debit side, expenditures if it is income in the credit side. Then we have sundry expenses which is 6,000, so let us record in the debit side, sundry expenses 6,000, then discount allowed 1,400, depreciation 4,000, then we have discount received which is an income, credit side discount received 1,700. Then we are going to close the account, the total of the credit side is excess again, where we have 52,000, and the same will be recorded in the debit side in the same line, 52,000, and minus the above entries, the difference will be 40,600, which is nothing but net profit which should be transferred to capital account. After preparing trading and profit and loss account, we have to prepare the final account which is called as balance sheet. So the title of the account will be balance sheet as at 31st March 2005, where the format of balance sheet will be liabilities amount, assets amount. So liabilities, we are going to record all the liabilities here, and in the asset we are going to record the asset. But what are the adjustments given that we have to adjust in the balance sheet? So where we have only one adjustment, where the depreciation have to be charged at 10% per annum on washing equipment. So now let us record the entries first in the liabilities side, where we have capital, which is 55,600. We'll record this in the inner column. Then we are going to add the profit, which is 40,600, the net profit. Then we are going to deduct the less drawings, or the drawings have to be deducted to ascertain the net balance. So here capital 55,600, add profit 40,600, then the total will be 96,200, then less drawings 8,000, and the balance to the outer column 88,200. And we have creditors, which is again a liability, creditors 6,800. Now let us record the entries in the asset side, where we have fixed asset, which is washing equipment 40,000 in the inner column, less depreciation 4,000, and outer column 36,000. Then we have furniture, no adjustment for that, furniture 3,000, stock of material 16,000, debtors 12,000, cash 28,000. So closing cash we are going to consider here, which is 28,000. Now we are going to close the balance sheet, where the total of both the side is 95,000 and 95,000. Then again, the capital balance is not given, so that we have to prepare a statement of affairs. So now let us see first how total debtors accounts to be prepared. So here the title will be total debtors account, and the format will be of ledger account, where debtors is an asset. First we are going to take opening balance in the debit side, balance brought down 90,000. Then we have cash received, so which will be recorded in the credit side, cash 30,000. Then we have discount allowed 1,400, and closing balance of debtors, balance carried down 12,000. And we have to close the account. Total of the credit side is 43,400, and the same in the debit side, 43,400. Minus the opening balance, so difference is 34,400, where it is nothing but the sales, which is credit. In the bracket we can write balancing figure. So here the sales, what we have here, to this the cash sales were added and it was included in the trading account. Then we have total creditors account to be prepared to ascertain the credit purchases. So where creditors is nothing but the liability, today or tomorrow we have to pay for the purchases made on the credit basis. So when coming to the liability, the opening balance will be in the credit side and closing balance will be on the debit side. First we are going to record the opening balance in the credit side, balance brought down 14,400. Then in the debit side we are going to write the payments made, cash 20,000 and discount received 1,700, and closing balance, balance carried down 6,800. Then we have to close the account to find out the balancing figure, which is nothing but the credit purchases. So when coming to the debit side, total is excess, which is 28,500. Same we have to record in the credit side, 28,500, and we have to deduct the opening balance, so the difference is 14,100. It is nothing but purchases, in bracket we can write credit and balancing figure. So these purchases plus the cash purchases, which is given in the cash summary, was shown in the trading account. And coming to the preparation of balance sheet, we have capital, which is of 55,600, which is ascertained with the help of statement of affairs, which is on the closing date. So now statement of affairs as at March 31st 2004, it will be similar to the balance sheet, liabilities amount and assets amount. So coming to the liabilities side, we have information which is creditors. Other than that we don't have any information. But when coming to the assets, we have washing equipments, furniture, stock of material, debtors and cash. By considering this information, we have to find out the capital, which will be the balancing figure. So let us record the entries first in the asset side. We have washing equipment 40,000, furniture 3,000, stock of material 10,000, debtors 9,000, cash 8,000. So the total assets we have is 70,000. But when coming to the liabilities side, we have only information of creditors, where creditors were 14,400. So same total will be considered again in the liabilities side, 70,000 minus creditors 55,600 is what capital. So the capital in bracket we can write balancing figure. This capital was shown in the balance sheet.